potentially break out above 220, which it's flirting with right now, snap that downtrend, and then what I would do is I would ride it higher and roll my stop up systematically. Every Friday, take a look at the weekly close and make that determination. I don't want to own it if it does break below that recent support. I know that the senior analyst that we're going to talk about put out a note talking about there's a tactical opportunity here because there's their first investor day in 10 years. I don't think they would call it investor day for the first time in a decade if they wanted to let everyone down. So it seems likely they'll put some long-term targets out there, possibly reaffirm this year's guidance, maybe even talk about increasing the dividend. Some of those things should be good enough for the stock to have that support. I think we're in this bear market rally as well. I know I've been saying that for a long time, maybe it gets boring, but that doesn't mean there aren't shorter-term opportunities and things that you can do if you want to. So fundamentally, if they can earn $20 a share over the next year, and they can affirm that guidance, I don't see any reason why the stock couldn't trade 13, 14 times that number. That would put it at about 250, and I'd be happy with 20% upside for a potential of 10% downside risk.
I mean, technicals could be as good a reason as any to buy a stock. He's making it clear that it's not necessarily for an extraordinarily long period of time that he may buy it, but nonetheless, what do you make of it?
Well, I love that this has the opportunity to get technically find out a good reason to own it, and you can look at it from a fundamental perspective and also find a good reason to own it. So what I love about this conversation is this would not be for the dividend portfolio, this would be for our different growth portfolio. And what we're talking about now is we're kind of real growth companies. So I think we're confused what growth companies are over the past couple of years. We thought of growth companies as very good share prices that were still up and up and up. But FedEx should have earnings that were up and up and up, and they're not these stratospheric levels. They're at reasonable levels. So now you get this huge discount, 30% off, trading at 12 times. It's got decent earnings growth ahead. It's achievable. It's a fantastic company that you own. It could work out every day of life.
So if you believe all of that, right, you're making a fundamental case to own it.
Yeah.
Does Josh's technical take sway you to do it now?
Yeah.
Why not?
It's just not our process. And every portfolio manager has to be true to and disciplined to following their process and not straying on it. So sometimes the technicals make you speed up on your process, but you still need to go through it. You still need to look at it and say, what are the ones here? How much does this make sense? And what do I have in the portfolio that isn't going to go as fast? So last week we talked about selling Amgen and buying Uber, right? Amgen is still growing, because that could be a good growth. So now you look at FedEx and say, is there enough growth and capital appreciation in the shares that makes it a replacement for something that we currently own?
Yeah, she used to own FedEx, right?
Yep, and the trade, it hits 200 or below the stretch points I would buy it. Frankly, I just missed it this time. And I do believe, look, you've got a new CEO, you've got the first investor day analyst day in 10 years. They're not coming off to say, hey, you know, we're cutting our earnings by the
time. And they're all the bullshit.
Right. So it's going to be an inauguration, and those are generally celebratory. The only question I have is, how much is in the stock market? And I would buy that. There is a one-to-one correlation framework with UPS. So from Jenny's standpoint, if I were her, I'd be looking at UPS with dividend portfolio with a much higher yield. Look, I like the fundamentals. Freight prices up there. The question is, when you go into recession, undoubtedly, those prices are